The focus of this lesson is on finding the least common multiple for a set of expressions. So in order to find the least common multiple, we have to be able to factor each of the expressions. So I'm going to go ahead and start off with 12y to the 7th. And we're going to work on factoring 12y to the 7th. So let's focus on the number piece of 12y to the 7th. So if you recall, in order to factor it, let's think about the prime factor tree. And you basically just want to come up with two numbers that multiply together to give you 12. So there's a couple different options. I'm going to go ahead and pick 4 times 3. You could have picked 6 times 2. That would have worked too. And then from there, take each of those numbers and ask yourself, can they break down further? So 4 could break down into 2 times 2. And then 3 cannot break down further. And then I look at each of those 2s, can they break down further? And they cannot. So they're only break down into 2 and 1. And so that's as far as they can go. And so we would say that this is the prime factorization, the ends of all of our branches. So 2 times 2 times 3. So when I go to write the factorization of 12y to the 7th, I can write it as 2 times 2 times 3 times y to the 7th. Well, then I would go ahead and do similarly for the next expression, which is 4y. And again, I'm going to focus on the number piece of 4y first. And two numbers that multiply together to give you 4 are 2 and 2. I go to break 2 down, but it can only break down into 2 and 1, so therefore 2 is prime, and the same would go for this 2. So 4y is 2 times 2 times y. And I'm just spacing that out so that the 2's line up and the y's line up. And then I would go ahead and do similarly for the expression 6x. And we'll start with the number piece of 6x. 6 is 3 times 2. And then if I look at 3, it can only factor into 3 and 1, so it's considered prime. And 2 can only factor into 2 and 1, so it's considered prime. So 6x can be written as 2 times 3, that's the 6 piece, times x. So now, let's go ahead and put that all together so that we can get the least common multiple. So the least common multiple has to be big enough that 12y to the 7th, 4y, and 6x divide into it, which means that all of their factors divide into the least common multiple. So if we start off with 12y to the 7th, it says that we need the factors 2 times 2 times 3 times y to the 7th. We can't leave any of those off, or 12y to the 7th would not divide into our least common multiple. And then if we look at 4y, 4y says that we need a 2 and a 2 and a y. So that's already accounted for, so we don't have to write anything additional in our least common multiple. And then for 6x, it says that we need a 2, a 3, and an x. Now we are missing the x piece, so we need to multiply that piece in, and then we have all of the factors for each of the numbers that are expressions that were listed there, and so that makes our least common multiple. So now what we can do is we can go ahead and multiply the number pieces together. So 2 times 2 is 4 times 3 is 12, and then we're left with the y to the 7th x. So if you had to find the least common multiple for 12y to the 7th, 4y, and 6x, you would come up with 12y to the 7th x.